إِنَّا أَنذَرْنَاكُمْ أشهد أن and my sister women has a baby for the sake of prayer, for the sake of consultation of the Imam, we would very much appreciate if you can kindly take care of the baby. If you cannot stop him or her, we would recommend advise you kindly, inshallah, to perform the prayer outside. Jazakumullah khairan kathira. Sorry for giving this message, but it's important for the concentration of prayer. Shukran.
Assalamu alaikum.
الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله
بالله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعله عوجا قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدنه ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا ماكثين فيه أبدا وينذر الذين قالوا أخذ الله ولدا ما لهم به من علم ولا لآبائهم كبرت كلمة تخرج من أفواههم إن يقولون إلا كذبا فلعلك باثع نفسك على آثارهم إن لم يؤمنوا بهذا الحديث يا سلام وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وإليه المصير وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله تعالى بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبي الرحمة وشفيع الأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله الأطهار وأصحابه الأخيار ومن اتبع سنته وسار على نفسه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد يا عباد الله اتقوا الله وأطيعوه إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. قال الله تعالى في محكم كتابه الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر صدق الله العظيم. وقال رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم من قام ليله القدر ايمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه صدق رسول الله. Honorable Muslims, in the verse I have recited at the beginning of the khutbah, Allah Almighty, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, states in the Surah Al-Qadr, indeed, we send the Quran down during the night of the decree. And what can make you know what is the night of the decree? The night of the decree is better than 1,000 months. The angels and spirits descend during high noon by permission of their Lord for everyone. Peace, it is unto the merchants of dawn. In the hadith I have read, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives the following goodness. Whoever spends the night of Qadr in prayer out of faith and in the hope of the Lord, his previous sins will be forgiven. Dear believers, we are in the last days of Ramadan, the beginning of which knows mercy, the middle of which forgiveness, and the end of which salvation from hell. These exceptional days are the days among which is hidden the Laylat al-Qadr, which is better than 1,000 months. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in one hadith, search for the night of Qadr in the last 10 days of Ramadan. The Laylatul Qadr is a sacred night during which Allah's grace and mercy shower down on believers' hearts, overflow with love and compassion. ليلة القدر is a unique night that reminds us of what is that we have forgotten and reawakens our blinded consciousness. The Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns his ummah about this night as follows. Whoever is deprived of the goodness of this night is like deprived of the goodness of a thousand nights. Dear Muslims, what makes the Laylatul Qadr valuable is the Holy Quran that was revealed that night. The Quran is the Kalam Allah, the words of Allah, sent by our Lord, about which there is never any doubt. The Quran is dhikr, recitation of which is an act of worship. The Quran is al-Furqan, which distinguishes between what is true and what is untrue, as well as what is straight and what is not straight. The Quran is a hikmah in which we divine address and warning are conveyed in all of its norms. The Quran is Mubin, which clearly shows the right path to all people to come until the last day. It is Aziz, which exalts both in this world and hereafter those who adopt its orders as principles and spend their life in line with the Quran. Dear believers, the last days of Ramadan are also the time for i'tikaf. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam would prefer i'tikaf in the last 10 days of Ramadan. I'tikaf is a refreshment of a believer's consciousness of servitude by staying away from worldly affairs. It means being busy day and night with worship and contemplation, thanking and praising Allah, repenting and asking Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. Thus, we may have opportunity to face ourselves. That way, we can remember our responsibilities and after life, which we have forgotten in the rush of life. Let us view the last 10 days of Ramadan and Laylatul Qadr as a divine grace and blessings for us. Let us embrace the Quran with our minds and hearts. Let us recite it more, understand it better, live up and uplift. Let us show regret for and turn away from our mistakes and sins. Let us the value of every night and be thankful for every blessing, so that we may have our entire life blessed. Thus, we may be able to succeed to the Jannatul Firdaws that Allah promises for His believing servants. Dear Muslims, sadly, in yet another month of Ramadan, there are a attempts to turn Al-Quds, the land of peace and serenity, into a place of conflict. The sanctity and inviolability of Masjid Al-Aqsa, the first time on the Mi'raj, is being violated. Muslims are being prevented from worshipping in their own mosques, in their own homelands. It should be known, however, that Al-Quds is not just a plot of land. Al-Quds is the land of Islam. Dar es Salaam, land of peace. It is the shared heritage of humanity, where all religions have continued to exist fitly to sanctuary of Palestinians, but of all Muslims. Inshallah, our blood station, which has stood through history, will continue to stand by Masjid Al-Aqsa today and tomorrow, as it did yesterday. I would like to conclude this Friday's program with our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Following the supplication, Allahumma innaka afuwwun kareemun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. O Allah, you are most forgiving. And you love forgiveness. So forgive. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم التوفيق.
Unuttuğumuz değerleri hatırlatan, köleler vicdanlarımıza hayat sunan
eşsiz bir gecedir. Allah Resulü sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem bu gece hakkında ümmetini şöyle uyarmıştır. Bu gecenin hayrından mahrum kalan, bin ayın hayrından mahrum kalmış gibi. Kıymetli Müslümanlar, Kadir Gecesi'nin kıymeti kılan, o gece indirilen Kur'an-ı Kerim'dir. O Kur'an ki, Rabbimiz tarafından gönderildiğine asla şüphe olmayan Kelamullah'tır. Okunması ibadet olan zikirdir. Hak ile batılı, iyi ile kötüyü, eğri ile doğruyu birbirinden ayıran